secret Nazi nuclear bunkers, sunken hordes of silver, and lost World War II relics in the jungle. Here are 10 of some of the greatest discoveries from World War II. Number 10. Secret Nazi nuclear bunker. When you think about the Nazis, you typically think about lunatic German soldiers shouting angrily and doing some pretty horrendous stuff. You don't typically think about ants. But in fact, the Nazis were basically a bunch of ants. They burrowed all underneath Europe, constructing all kinds of underground tunnels and bunkers, with some of them only being found now. For example, a filmmaker in Austria just discovered a network of underground bunkers in 2019 that had been used by the Nazis in their attempts to develop an atomic bomb. This happened just outside a small town near Linz. Its location was determined using old intelligence reports and radiation tests. The filmmaker actually utilized a report from the 1940s from an American spy who thought there was a secret weapons program in the area. And yeah, it turns out there really was. The facility was built using the slave labor from a nearby concentration camp and covered around 75 acres. It's now believed that the underground tunnels connect to the famous Bergkristall factory, where the first jet-powered fighter planes were built. It's crazy that they never found this site until now, as according to The Independent, professionals believe it was the largest weapons facility in the Third Reich. So far, many interesting artifacts have been recovered, including Nazi relics and helmets from the SS. Unfortunately, the filmmaker and his crew were actually stopped by the police, as they did not have a permit to excavate a historical site. But hopefully, the dig can begin again soon. Number 9. Sunken Silver. When the Nazis fired their torpedoes at the SS Gairsoppa during the Second World War, carrying $240 million in silver bars and coins, not that it would have done the Nazis much good in the end, but if they had known, they probably would not have sunk the ship. They would have robbed it. Now, the ship is set to be the biggest ever find from beneath the sea. A company from the US, Odyssey Marine Exploration, was working with the British government a few years ago to set up a plan for recovering the sunken vessel. It was originally torpedoed and sunk on its way to Ireland in 1941, but its exact coordinates are still unknown. The Marine Exploration Company is trying to gather its exact location so that they can go down and retrieve all that booty. And who can blame them? Finding over $200 million in silver is every treasure hunter's dream. If they really do get it to the surface and recover all that silver, it'll be the largest ever collection of precious metal pulled out of the ocean. However, there's a lot of preparation that goes into such a project, and if they don't find the silver, they could take a serious hit. According to ABC News, there are an estimated 3 million shipwrecks sitting at the bottom of the world's oceans. Out of those 3 million, the Marine Exploration Company has 6,300 as potential targets, with at least 100 of those claiming a retail value of at least $50 million. Number 8. The Musashi Battleship Wreck. What do you do if you're an American billionaire with an obsession for World War II relics? Well, if you're Paul Allen, you put together your own exploration team and start looking for shipwrecks. This is exactly what happened back in 2015 when Mr. Allen discovered the sunken Japanese battleship, the Musashi, after it was sunk over 70 years ago by the United States forces. He used his own private exploration team to discover it sitting at the bottom of the ocean near the Philippines, 3,280 feet below the surface. Out of all the Japanese battleships in the war, the Musashi was one of the largest, and that makes it an incredible find, especially since it was so recent. The battleship itself was sunk by United States warplanes on the 24th of October 1944. This happened at the Battle of Leyte Gulf, which is believed to be the biggest naval battle of World War II, and it was the decisive battle in which American and Australian militaries brutally defeated the Japanese armada. This is a serious piece of history, and while Mr. Allen can't exactly bring the vessel to the surface, BBC reports that he is still very pleased at discovering the ship, as it had taken him around 8 years to find. Number 7. Carrier pigeon in the chimney. Forget sunken ships and forget warplanes. One of the coolest World War II discoveries ever was the carrier pigeon found in a chimney. People from the United States are not that familiar with carrier pigeons, but in Britain they get a lot of respect. They have a huge historical significance in the United Kingdom. Carrier pigeons were actually used during the war to send messages between the Allied powers. There was not much Hitler could do to infiltrate messages tied to the feet of pigeons, though there were snipers who were trained to shoot down messenger pigeons, and the Nazis also had hawks that were specially trained to kill the pigeons and intercept the messages. But this didn't always work. A man named David Martin told CBS News that he found the remains of a carrier pigeon when he was opening a fireplace that had been boarded up for 30 years. During the cleaning, it became apparent that there had once been a bird using the top of the chimney for its roost, but obviously it was the last roost that bird would ever use. Upon closer inspection, David found attached to one of the pigeon's bones a red capsule with a spool inside. On that spool was a message from the war, written in code. Martin could not decipher the code because he obviously had no idea how, but it was still a pretty incredible find. Number 6. The P-40 Kitty Hawk. On June 28, 1942, Sergeant Dennis Copping was flying his damaged P-40 Kitty Hawk between two British airfields located in Egypt. The plan was to get the plane repaired. However, the 24-year-old soldier crash-landed in the middle of the desert, and the aircraft sat there for over 70 years until found again in 2012. If you've ever been to the deserts of Egypt, you'll know that the Sahara is a massive and wildly untouched place. It's inhospitable, and there's no reason for anyone to wander out into it. It's absolutely no surprise that the plane sat there for so long. The plane had remained largely intact, though it had been pretty badly damaged from the sand. Interestingly enough, the plane was found, but the pilot's remains were not. The man who discovered it, a Polish oil company worker, contacted the Egyptian authorities, who then came and stripped the plane of its guns and ammunition before locals figured out it was there, and came to strip the plane for scrap metal. Unfortunately, the saddest part of the story is that the pilot likely took off in search of safety and was swallowed by the desert. His bones will probably never be found. Number 5. The USS Independence. The USS Independence was an impressive aircraft carrier used during the war. It operated from between 1943 and 1945 in the Pacific Ocean. Then, it became one of the vessels in a target fleet for atomic bomb testing in Bikini Atoll. It was damaged by shockwaves and radiation, and was eventually sent back to the United States, where it was intentionally sunk off the coast of San Francisco. It then sat at the bottom of the ocean for quite a bit of time before the technology came around for us to go down and take a look at a classic piece of history. According to Live Science, researchers used a robotic submarine to conduct the first visual survey of the wreck just a few years ago, and what the survey revealed was pretty fantastic. They clearly did not disassemble the ship that well before they sunk it. You can still see the 40mm anti-aircraft guns on the top of the aircraft, only now, they're surrounded by giant sponges and other thriving sea life. This machine, which had once been used for war and to test the effectiveness of horrendous atomic bombs, is now oddly peaceful as part of the ocean. It's its own kind of habitat, sitting upright 2,600 feet below the waves, just off the coast of California. Number 4. The Japanese Mega Sub. The Japanese I-400 class submarine was easily one of the most impressive war machines of the 1940s. It was the largest submarine ever built, and it kept the title of largest until the 1960s when nuclear ballistic missile submarines went into production. But in the 1940s, it was a mega sub. It had the ability to travel around the entire world 1.5 times without needing to refuel. It also had the ridiculous capacity to carry 3 airplanes while under the water. It was designed specifically to attack the continental United States. This is something a lot of people aren't familiar with. These massive submarines were actually designed to sneak up to the shores of North America, then launch their destructive weapons at cities on the coast while deploying aircraft. If any of these vehicles had reached the shore, it would have caused thousands and thousands of civilians to lose their lives. Luckily, only 3 of these subs were ever built. They ended up being destroyed by the Americans after the war to keep the Soviets from getting their hands on the technology. But the location of the wrecks remained largely a secret until 2005, at which point one of the submarines was found by an undersea research laboratory out of Hawaii. The wreck is almost 3,000 feet under the ocean, and so it's likely that its secrets will remain with it. Number 3. Panther Tank in the Basement. Everyone dreams of owning a tank. Arnold Schwarzenegger has one. Why can't I? Well, in 2015, police in northern Germany seized a World War II Panther tank that was being kept inside a senior citizen's home. The man in question was 78 years old at the time, and he'd been hoarding the Panther tank, along with some other pretty impressive military equipment, such as a torpedo and an anti-aircraft gun. As reported by the BBC, it was no easy job getting all that stuff out of the guy's basement. The army had to be called, and they actually had to bring a modern tank to get the Panther tank out of the old man's cellar. It apparently took 20 soldiers a full 9 hours to remove the tank, and now the city is investigating the man's military collection, as it could be in violation of the War Weapons Control Act. But considering the man is almost 80 years old, it's pretty doubtful if he really cares. And in any case, None of the weapons were operational. But what I want to know is, how big is this guy's basement? He had a giant anti-tank gun and a full Panther tank. That's a pretty big basement. And how did he get them down there in the first place? According to locals, it was actually pretty common knowledge that he had the tank. They even say he'd been seen driving it in a freak snowstorm over 30 years ago. Number 2. The ME-262 aircraft. In the Netherlands, the substantial remains of an ME-262 Schwalbe jet fighter have been discovered buried under the ground. The discovery came completely by accident. While workers from the Delen Air Base Museum were working to excavate a World War II bomb crater at a nearby airfield, they wanted to dig in that area because bomb craters are often full of all kinds of trash and relics from the war. It might have been trashed 70 years ago, but today, a lot of people consider that stuff treasure. During the digging, the workers found the nose of the jet fighter along with its four gun ports. The windshield was easily recognizable, as was the heavily armored glass. And not to forget the two MK-108 30mm nose-mounted cannons. Because the team was not a real archaeological team, they had actually started their dig by hand. It took them all day with their hands to dig out the nose of the craft, but they couldn't get out the wing section. They had to send for bigger equipment, and when all was said and done, they ended up unveiling the entire aircraft. It was a very historical find, considering the workers believed the plane to be a Stormbird fighter bomber variant, which were pretty rare overall in the war, and one of Germany's most secretive air weapons. Number 1. World War II relic in the jungle. World War II planes are basically scattered all over the world, and some of them are only now being found. Take the Japanese Mitsubishi G4M1 Betty bomber, recently discovered in the Balale Island in the Solomons, which had been rotting in the jungle for over 70 years. And it's not the only one. There was another G4M attack bomber also decaying amidst the otherwise secluded forest. These aircrafts were better known by the Allies as codename Betty, and were a mainstay of the Imperial Japanese bombing fleet. They had amazing range and a significant amount of armor. They had self-sealing fuel tanks and were extremely hard to bring down. During the war, they were used as medium-altitude bombers, torpedo bombers, and transport units. These were also the planes used in the brutal attack at Pearl Harbor. Currently, there are no complete Betty aircrafts preserved in the world. That makes the recovery of these two planes in the Solomon Islands so incredible. The frames were almost completely intact, other than the obvious damage. They've even been traced with their unique model numbers, and it turns out both planes came out of the factory in Nagoya back in 1943. Because of how remote the island is, and the lack of human settlements, the two aircrafts have remained exactly where they fell from the sky until they were recovered. But getting these huge aircrafts out of the jungle was no easy task. The recovery team had to cut a pathway through the trees, and then use crude sleds made from tree branches to haul each individual item down to the beach where it could eventually be shipped off the island. Which of these amazing World War II discoveries fascinates you the most? Let me know in the comments section. As always, thanks for watching. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe for all the best new videos.